Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a Shopify how to video, and in today's video I'm going to teach you guys how you can add sticky bar on your product page of Dawn theme. And your sticky bar will look like this. So when you scroll down and past the add to cart button, you will see a bar which will have all of your product information, product image, product title, quantity selector and pricing, and an add to cart button which you can click and add your product to your cart. And that's the desktop version, and that's how it will look on your mobile version. So let me refresh. That's how it will look on your mobile version. And when you have variants in your product, so let me show you how that version will look like. So this is a simple product without any variants, and now this product have variants. Now when we go to that product and we have variants, that's how it will look. As you can see, each variant have different pricing. And similarly, if we have multiple variation in our products, let me show you how then it will look like. So it will have all of the options in the drop down menu. So as you can see, this product have multiple variations, sizing and color. And when you scroll down and past the add to cart button, it will look like this. So as you can see, all the available variants are showing up with the options and colors. And it will show only available variants. So for example, if a variant is not available, it will not show in the drop down menu. So for example, small in black, as you can see, it's unavailable. It's not in quantity. So that's why it's not showing up in the drop down menu. Cool, right? So if you want to learn how to add this sticky bar on your product page of your Dawn theme, stick to the video. Don't forget to comment on the video below if you have any confusion implementing this on your theme. And we are implementing this in Dawn 7.0.1, which is the latest version. If you are trying to implement this on any other theme, it might not work, but you can get a head start. And if you want help implementing that on your own theme, comment down on the video below and I'll definitely help you guys. So without further ado, let's jump into the code. So guys, this is a 5-step tutorial and I'll walk you through step by step for where you will be adding the code. And this sticky bar can also be disabled and enabled through customize settings. So if you go to the customize in Dawn theme and go to products and then click on default product, you will have an option under product information. As you can see that enabled sticky bar. So if you disable it, as you can see, it's showing up now. Now when I disable it, uncheck it, it will not show up. And enable it again and it will show up. Cool. So now let's go to the first step. Let's go to our Shopify backend by navigating to /admin. And from there, we will click on online store from a left-hand menu. And in there, I have already added the latest version of Dawn theme. So that's the theme where I've already added all of the codes. And that's the fresh Dawn theme version 7.0.1, which I added just 48 minutes ago. So I'm going to publish that one. Click publish. And now when I go back to my product page and hit refresh, there is no sticky bar showing up, right? Now let's add that in our latest theme. Now click on these three dots and click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to duplicate your theme and have a backup of it. So if in case you mess up anything with the code, you can easily revert it back. Now click on edit code. And first, we will be adding jQuery in our theme. That's the first step of our tutorial. So we'll be navigating to theme.liquid. And in this file, we will add jQuery. And how to add that? So we'll just Google jQuery CDN. And here we will have option of the first option. We'll click on that. And here we have the latest version showing up, which is jQuery 3.6.1. Click on the minified version and copy the code from here. Paste it under head. So I'm adding that on line number 10. So I have added the jQuery. Now click save. Now the second step is to go to main-product.liquid file. So that's our file, and we will be adding our schema settings to enable and disable it from customize, right? And now I'm gonna search for sticky, and so we will add our new options in customize setting just below that. So it's line number 1830. You can add code below that, and that's the code which I will be adding. Don't worry about the codes. I'll add all of the codes in the blog post, which you will find in YouTube video description. Okay, you just copy this code and paste it here. By the way, guys, if you like the content which I create and I put a lot of effort in it, so please don't forget to subscribe my channel. It will help me motivate, create more quality content for you guys. Okay, so after adding this option, now if we go to our customize, we will see a new option. So let me show you guys. Now I'm gonna go to online store and customize online store. And customize. And from there, I'll go to products and then click on default product. From here, after clicking on product information, as you can see, we have this new option showing up, which is because of this code. So if I remove that and it's safe. And go back to my customize and hit refresh. You will see that enable sticky bar option will not be visible. There you go. You have just enabled sticky content on desktop. We are adding another option by this code. Okay, now we will add this code back. Now hit save. And now we have completed our second step. Now our third step is to add code in product-thumbnail.liquid file. And that's our file, product-thumbnail.liquid. Open that file, go down to the bottom of the file and add the liquid code, which I will provide you guys in the blog post. And blog post will also have details and step of where you will be adding the code. So don't worry if you have any confusions, check out that blog post where you will find all of the details. And after adding the code on the bottom of product-thumbnail.liquid file, click save, and that was our third step completed. Now we will be moving to our fourth step, which is adding JS code in global.js. So I'm gonna copy that JS code, go to the global.js file, and that's our global.js file. Scroll down to the bottom of that file and paste the code, it's safe, and we are done with our fourth step. Now, fifth and the final step of this code, which is adding CSS code in base.css file. And in base.css file, we'll scroll down to the bottom and add the CSS code. Now, copy the code and go down to the bottom of the file and paste the code. It's safe, and we are good with our tutorial. We are done with our tutorial. Now we will go to our product page and hit refresh to see how it looks. Okay, we just hit refresh, and now I'm going to hide that bar and scroll down, and here we go. Our product page sticky bar is showing up. So the image is a little skewed because of the resolution, which is really high in this image. Let's check out some other products. So that's another product. Scroll down to the bottom, and here we have our sticky bar showing up. Now you might have a add to cart button showing up on a different resolution, and in order to change the scroll bar height for desktop, you can edit the code in global.js. So you can change the value from this line. So that's the code for resolution, which are more than 1024 pixel. That's the JS code for that. So it says that if user scroll down 500 pixel, it will then display the sticky bar. Otherwise, it will display it none. So you can increase and decrease the value depending on your theme styling and theme art to add to cart button showing up. That's for desktop version. And if you scroll down, you will see if dollar window, which means it's less than 1024 pixel. So screen which are less than 1024 pixel, that's the pixel settings when user will scroll down past 900 pixel and your sticky bar will show up. So you can change these values here. Additionally, what you can do if you want this add to cart button to directly go to checkout. So currently it goes to the cart button. So let's, for example, add in 4 items of this product to your cart. Click on add to cart. And oops, I think there were more quantities added. Let's test it again. Delete it and add it back. Now I'm going to add 4 items of this product in my cart. Click add to cart. And here you go. As you can see, it's showing up 4 items in your cart completely fine. Now what you can do is you can make this button directly go to checkout. And in order to do that, I have this one line of code which you will add in product-thumbnail.liquid file just above this add to cart button. So I'm going to add that line. Hit save. And now the sticky bar add to cart button will directly go to checkout and it will skip the cart. Now let's hit refresh. And now when I click on this add to cart button, so it will add this quantity. We already had 4 items of this product in the cart. So when I'll click on add to cart now, it will directly go to the checkout with 5 products on it. So let's see. So here you go. It's directed to checkout directly with the 5 items in the quantity. There you go. You have 5 items of this product in your checkout page. Cool, right? And take a look at the mobile version as well. So that's the desktop version, and now switch to your mobile version. Hit refresh. Scroll down, and that's how our mobile version looks like. Looks good, right? Okay guys, that's it for the tutorial. If you guys liked it, make sure to subscribe the channel, like and comment. Until next video, have a great day.